Hello and welcome. Actually, generally we face power problem in our house. Like our network is our generally home router require external power to come up. So, but as soon as the power fluctuation will happen, which is more common in nowadays, and so when the power fluctuation will happen, the router will be rebooted, and it will take at least 5 minutes to come up. And then it will provide the power connectivity, so internet connectivity, so then only you can access the network. So in this solution which I tried in my home, and I am able to get the power like for power backup for at least 12 to 24 hours, and I am not using any UPS. Generally the UPS cost is very high. It's like for a normal Wi-Fi router also, it's like a 2,000 to 3,000 you have to spend from your pocket. Generally, we have in our house we have a power bank, which we can use as a, like our power backup solution. So let me start like how I created this solution. So you can understand the original problem. Like suppose this is our home Wi-Fi router, and it has two connections: one for external power, which we generally keep through our switchboard, home switchboard. Another one is related to Ethernet connection, which will come from the like centralized ISP router. Generally, it will be on the like they will put on the like terrace, and from there it will come to our house. So this is like a PoE enabled generally, so it does not require any power backup. This connection is always up, and even if you don't want to use home Wi-Fi router, you can directly connect to your laptop and you can get a power from there. So this connection is always up. We should worry about only this connection. Like suppose if your power goes off due to fluctuation, or like due to fluctuation your generator will restarted or inverter is restarted, so what will happen? So you have to wait at least 5 minutes to connect again to home Wi-Fi connection, and it will be worse if you have a like a VPN connection, because generally nowadays all people are doing working from home, so they saw like frequent power off and on, and most of the power due to power load, so they have to wait at least 10 minutes. And if suppose you are transferring some file, so your file transfer or upload or download will be interrupted due to this power fluctuation. So another question is like how we can resolve this problem. So like most of the people are we are using a power bank to charge our mobile, and nowadays because we are at home, so we don't require a power bank to charge our mobile, but we can use this device to give as a power to give power to our Wi-Fi router. But before giving going for actual usage, let's understand the power requirement of a router and a Wi-Fi router and our power bank. So this is the Wi-Fi router which I am using, like for which I am using for my router, and you can see that it requires external power supply 12 volt DC and 1 ampere current, and power bank will give output like input will be like 5 volt 2 ampere. This is for charging, and 9 volt 2 ampere and 12 volt 1.5 ampere for your output it will give. So it is matching exactly and it is fulfilling the requirement. So it will give output power output for 12 volt, and this will go to input as a 12 volt to our Wi-Fi router. So what external things we require to make this connection happen, or we as a power backup. So you require a power bank which can provide enough power supply to your Wi-Fi router. So you have to check the power rating of your Wi-Fi router and power bank, which should match with each other. Second thing, you require one power cable, like generally based upon like what kind of power port is there. Some router will provide like a USB kind of port, so you can use a USB to USB cable, and some provide like this pin kind of thing to USB connector. So this part you can connect to your power bank, this port, and this part you can connect to your Wi-Fi router. So this cable is easily available in Amazon and Flipkart in price of like 300-400 rupees only. So now, how you can make a connection properly? Okay, so make sure your power bank is charged properly and connection are smooth and router should up properly. Now you can have like a home router and connect this point or pin point to your router and particular output point into your power bank, and the ether connection will be like same like before. So this way, like your once it is done, so you should check that whether router is up, and through your laptop you are able to access the internet. So what precaution and we should take? So precaution should be like the power bank should be charged properly. Once it is connected to Wi-Fi router, make sure both device should not overheated. If it is overheated, you should remove the connection immediately, otherwise it can damage your router. Wi-Fi router and power bank should not power off on continuously, means the connection should not flap. If it is flapping, that means it is not fulfilling the power requirement. You can either charge your bank or supply to router, means the power bank will work as a like either it can work as a like a charging mode or supply mode. So you cannot use for both way. So like you can charge for at least once in a, like for 1 hour, and it's 1 hour or 2 hour, and it will give power supply for at least like 14 to 20 hours. And second thing, cable should be purchased based upon the power requirement and based upon the port which is supported by the Wi-Fi router. And some of the statics I would like to show, like I have a 10,000 mAh power bank, and I am able to charge that power bank in like within 2 hours fully charged, and after charging I am able to get the power backup for the like at least for 14 to 20 hours. So, and I have not seen any problem with respect to wireless signal coverage, and it's working like it before. No problem was not when you are using VPN connection to your organization. VPN is never getting connected in this particular hour, 14 to 20 hours. So this is like a common solution and very easily solution you can use it in your home, and it will benefit to all the people. Thanks.